Hey, it's Coolio. If you don't know, and it is time for some more of the Archimegalo, let's take a look at the board and see what we got. So right now, there is not a whole lot. Kirby in the Forgotten Land is down to about 10 checks. Yes, you do hear only me. It's fine. Kirby in the Forgotten Land is 10 checks. Thanks for letting me know, just in case, because sometimes things don't come through. Metroid Zero Mission has 6, and they're kind of spaced far apart. I might do that sooner rather than later. Tunic has pretty much almost all of the checks are in the quarry, so that's not ideal. And Meredith Skyden has 2 checks, which I'd be a little better. Meredith Skyden has 2 checks, has 1 chest and 1 pedestal are in logic, but I still don't have any psyches, which means I can't fight the first boss, which means there's not really a whole lot to do. So the one game that has the most checks that I'm comfortable getting right now is Final Fantasy XIV. So that's where we're going. Press the button. And hopefully things update like they should. Also, I need to, because the keyboard thing is dumb. Or the mouse, rather. There we go. Okay, so let's go to Studio D. Hello. Right now is also the Mughal treasure trove. I don't think, because the weekly is Cutter's Cry, which we've already done, so I'm not going to be doing it right now. Fates in Lakeland, unfortunately Lakeland is not yet in logic, and Kaluja I don't have access to yet. There's also Triple Triad, and Triple Triad's not even in the rando. And the Ultimog Challenge is Treasure Dungeons, which that's going to be a pain to even get done because I rarely have anyone to do treasure maps with. But what we can do is we have access to the peaks. We do the 5 baits there. There are some alliance raids on this list, and I've come to the conclusion that given that I did set it up so that nothing but a light party or solo should be in logic, I'm guessing that anything that is above that, so full party or alliance, should be just junk. I don't know if that's the case, but that's the conclusion I'm going with. I don't think there are any guild hests. They're currently showing as locked because I have it set down as restricted party. No, there are no guild hests, so I don't need to worry about this page. So I don't need to worry about queuing for anything. So let's go to the peaks and get those fates done, and then we can start clearing out dungeons. Let's go to Alba. Currently I have Reaper up to level 70 in logic. Oh, that one has 30 seconds on it. That one's almost complete. So I think Days of Lutarini Past is where we're going. kind of sucks because this one had a bonus attached to it when we got here too late, unfortunately. So yeah, nice thing about doing Shadowbringers, Stormblood and Beyond is you're gonna get people who are farming these. You're gonna get people who are farming these, so these might get done a little faster as a result. Should probably use a Gizzle Green. Just your standard butterflies, plus that guy in the back who's kind of interfering. It is kind of hilarious though, the amount of experience that I've gained just from doing the Archimegalo. I guess I can see where you're coming from, then. I'm still a ways off from level 91, but like, I have done nothing for actual like leveling effort for Reaper. I was getting pretty close to 91 already. Kind of rough. Come on. Where are you? It sucks that these have to be done synced now. Look at that, you've respawned. In just such a way that you've aggroed on me again. Great. Cool, alright. I don't know if I have a battery for the smoke detector. That might be a problem. It was fine until right now. Oh boy. I'm gonna finish this fate and I'm gonna go see if there's anything I can do about this. This might necessitate an emergency trip to the store that I wasn't planning on doing. That is not a down. I'm gonna go back to Alagana, just for safety's sake. Okay, let me go see if there's something that I can do about this right now, and hopefully I have some 9-volt batteries that I can stick into that thing. If not, I will let you know, and I'll probably need to go to like the corner store and get some. I was not expecting this to happen right now. I'll be right back. Good news, everyone. I had one, and it's in there now. Also, Grim, I would not be able to do that. The smoke detector is firmly fastened to the wall. Now, one slight worry that I have is that the date on the battery is 12/2023. It is an energizer, so hopefully it's still fine. If it can hold out for a few hours at least, we're good. Although if it can only hold out for a few hours and then gives out after stream, then I'm kind of screwed. Anyway, before that happened, we finished a fate. So let me go and find that on the list of the peaks. And I don't have anything up that tells me that's a gold questagon. All right. Well, let's head over to Moth to a Flame, like a moth to a flame. I should add, it's fastened to the wall and also wired to the mains, so there ain't no taking it. Perfectly fine, yeah? That's number two. Firebomb tank. Alright, definitely use more of those. I don't know if I have time for this. I definitely have time for that one, though. And another one spawned over here. Also haven't checked, but I'm hoping that the check count has been updating correctly. I think I resolved the problem last time and didn't actually change anything since then. Tough sand for 5 year energy. Love some of these names. Nice and punny. Okay. Another mobs one here, so. They're not too bad. As long as I remember to put on my damage buff. Okay, the wild back is a lightning spray, it won't aggro unless I hit it.
Yeah.
Okay. And that is 5 fates. And some experience, yay. Antidote for Dying Spinner. Whoopee. Alright. Let's head back home and start doing some dungeons. I'm only gonna do the 4-man ones, and I am going to do them unsynced so that we can get through this as quickly as possible. I'll just do them in alphabetical order. And some of these are also part of the Moogle treasure trove, so I will get some irregular tome stones for them. I'm honestly surprised at the fact that I'm getting so many levels of Reaper more than anything else. I guess the randomizer does not have any way of knowing that, like, Bard would be ideal. It just knows which classes are better than the others. And so I have it configured that it's especially focused on, because I have to have one class of each role. So I have Bard, Reaper, Summoner, Scholar, and Dark Mage. Dark Mage. Dark Knight. Although, if Scholar starts to pull ahead, then I might have some problems, because I didn't do the job quests for Summoner. Like, none of them. So I'm missing a bunch of abilities. So I just hope that I can just ride Reaper to the end. It's kind of fun to see some of these dungeons though, because like they don't really come up all that often in roulettes. Not that they don't come up at all, but not that often. Sitting there doing nothing. Yeah, man. Hurry up. Oh yeah, this actually that might explain why this one doesn't come up in roulettes, because I think this room actually has a time limit. And usually if something has a time limit aside from the duty clock, it gets excluded from roulettes. It's actually literally the only reason that Earth's found is not in roulette. Because it actually has an enrage timer. Even though, like, mechanics wise, it's actually not that bad. The static group that I am in just recently did Earth's Found, and I healed through it, and that was a little rough, I'm gonna tell you. Okay, also I'm gonna double check and make sure this is getting updated. So, that is Dungeons, ARR, Amphidor Key. Yes, it is getting updated, and that is 50 coins to clear. Put this back over here. And the next one is Castrum Abania. I think I just did last night. Now, I don't think this is the one that I did last night. It's doing worse stuff, not looking at numbers. That's fine. Big important work guy. Although listening to me makes booking travel easier, does it? I'm here fussing about Eorzean geography. Yes, we'll fly round trip coast from Los Angeles to wow, that fell apart. Where would you want to travel to? I guess Kugane would be a pretty good one. In other words, not Japan. Oh, this dungeon, okay. I've realized now which one this is. I don't think this is the one that I did last night. Oh, this is level 90? Oh, this might be a little rougher than I thought. No, this is... I'm level 90 because of... Oh my goodness, I'm a doofus. No, I'm level 90 because I'm unsynced. This is not a level 90 dungeon. Castor and Bonnie is level 70. Yeah, because this guy is level 69.
Chat can see it.
I don't think I ever implied that I am a sink. Of any kind. I said that I wasn't in sync. I don't know when I said that. Oh, level sync. God. spelling is... Spelling makes a world of difference. You see. I forget if I gained something at level 91. Doesn't look like it. Yeah, I gained something at level 92. Alright, now I need to break these things. Gotten by without good English. Pardon me, I am French, Derda. Also, I think I know what I want to play after the Archimegalo. I'm going to want something... a bit of a power cleanser, obviously. I have a pretty good idea of what that's going to be. And then we'll get back to the long run after that. Provided, of course, that I remember what my plan is, because I don't know how far in the future this is going to be. Unfortunately, this boss has a body check mechanic. There we go. We got through it. Also, let me check something real quick. Maybe it was... okay, that's what it was. I heard a noise and was not sure what it was. Now I am pretty sure I know what it is, but it's fine. bulk up a tomato paste and makes pizza a vegetable and tomatoes a fruit. Somehow I didn't realize this was already the third boss. I was hoping that maybe the Orquestrian roll would drop. Alas, no. Let's see. So that was Heaven's Word? No. Stormringers, there it is. Access to Western Lana Sea. We have 5 more fates to do. Oh boy, and I get to do Sastasha again. So excited. Let's go to Lana Sea. That's that one. Let's see. It's probably less likely to get people here because you don't really get a whole lot from grinding these fates. Are going to be so low level, but I don't have any buttons to work with. It kind of sucks, actually. Like, I don't have any AoEs at all. I also can't use my Hell's Ingress, so I can't just forward jump to enemies. I do at least have my heart. Getting a lot of like trash. Okay, let's see if I can help this out a little bit. Surely I have 10 levels of barter, right? I have 30 levels of bard. Then I'm gonna use something that gives me a little bit of range. And for our first fate, we get a blue door in Astalon and Gorgon Tomb. Oh, these are higher level though, and actually people are working on these, which kind of worries me. This one barely has any time left. This one's almost done. None of these 4 fates are any good. I'm gonna try to get to this one, but I don't know if I'll even be able to finish it. That one's already gone. This one's almost done. This one is too close to done for it to count, really. Oh. I am worried that this might be one of the big ones. I'm going to try it. Okay, let's see. Oh, and someone else dropped by. We're gonna finish this one for sure. Provided I don't get lost in these caves, this is a dead end. Where is it? Is it on the other side of this? Yeah, it's this one. Alright. Oh shoot, right. I can't do this as, I just realized I can't do this as Bard. I have to do it as Reaper. So that last fate doesn't count. I only have 30 levels of Bard. And I did a fate that is more than 3 levels higher than that. That's not in logic, that's invalid. However, I think this is a double, so that'll help a little bit. Oh, this is the guy that I told you. There we go. And that's a gold. That's a waddle dee. Let's move on. There's another fate over here. This time I'm correctly equipped as Reaper. I'm just gonna use Bard for those lower level ones. I have some range that I can work with. Appreciate it, sir, if you didn't interfere. I wonder why people would be farming fates here. Because like, Stormblood Onward, there's the shared fate system and you actually get rewards for doing fates. Here you just pretty much only get like experience and maybe some company seals, whatever this is. Anyway, that was a valid clear. Okay, that one's almost done. There's no sense for me to get to that one. Go do Goblin Chain over there, and then I'll reveal the third fate. peanuts for a la carte. So yeah, the big things that I need right now are access to Northern Thanalan, which is okay, this one I can do as Bard. So level 15. So yeah, Northern Thanalan is in Paradox Cave. Also, I'm trying to think. 5 levels of Reaper will give me actual access to Shadowbringers areas. Because I do have access to Lakeland and I think Lakeland, Illmeg, and the Tempest, if I recall correctly. Tempest would require another 10 levels, but 5 levels would just need the other two. Actually, I think I have Armoring as well. Looking over at the client. Hey, you're good now. I don't have armoring. Okay. Alert. So, fate number 4 is a 1 HP for Astalon, and I just died in 6 arms tonight. I do feel like the puns are a little better in AR. Honestly. You, sir, can go away. Buzzard? More like buzz off. Yep, and that's fine. That's good. Yeah. And definitely use that. Mm-hmm. Guess which game is no longer in BK and actually probably can get a lot done in. I don't know how many Waddle Dees I need to unlock the next boss is the thing. But yeah, the gravity boots will allow me to get almost anywhere in the castle, honestly. Not quite everywhere, but that is big mobility. So finally, something to break open a game. We're going to keep going for this for a little bit at least. I'm thinking at least until break. Okay, so alphabetically the next one is Emanation. That is a trial, so I'll skip it. So I need to be a Reaper for this. Kogane Castle is the next one in line. That's Stormblood, right? Haven't been to this one in a while, I don't think. I will always say, like, the music for Kugane just makes me want to play Xenoblade. So this has that feel to it. I guess I have to clear everything. This ain't one of those ARR dungeons where you can just leave. You just pull the entire dungeon if you want to. I basically had no intention of playing Kirby today unless it was the only thing that could really that really had any advancement. Oh, you're pulsating. I probably want to move away from you. The hug ore. Actually, like, just a few days ago, I was watching Joecat and Shentai do a round of Final Fantasy XIV knockout bingo. And basically what that means is, so obviously bingo, but once one person claims a square, the other person cannot claim that square. So sometimes it gets to be a race of like, well, there's an easy square, or there's like a square that will give you a chance for a line or something like that, or give you a line and you have to make the block, and it's like, who's gonna get it first type of thing. I found that kind of fascinating. Like, I'd never seen someone play like a competitive bingo thing like that before. Definitely something that I would like to try sometime. Oh, Steffi, hello. How you doing? Lockout bingers are... Oh, it's a lockout, yes, not knockout. My bad. A big noted streamer, one of the top world record holders. Nice. Yeah, I would be interested in doing some lockout bingo or something. Maybe even Final Fantasy 14. It just kind of comes down to having someone to do that with, and also getting all the, you know, necessary setup ready. AP lockout bingo runs away. I mean, that is doable. I can kind of think of a way to do that. However, I already have like at least three other archipelago things that like I have the ambition to do, but not the will. It's kind of a similar idea to that one thing that that Far did like a couple of years ago on the April Fool's Day, where he did like that Candyland thing. There's a lot of things, of weird things that you can do with archipelago. This is a little rough to do with oh no. Please stop, sir. Usually you have four people picking up this money. It's not that big of a worry though, as long as the funds don't get to 100. Because if it gets to 100, then it'll probably throw an instant kill. And I did not get an orchestra roll. Oh well. That was Coogan and Castle. That is dungeons in Stormblood. Castle, 5 rusty bits. The next one on the list is Pharaoh Sirius, which I think is Heaven's Award, specifically hard. I would not recommend eating corrupted blonde. That seems like a bad idea. Now, I really should remind myself on the lore of Feral Seer just because, like, how did it end up getting so connected? Oh, why am I on this pipe? I wouldn't be surprised if the Umbral Colony had something to do with it. Bahamut, yeah. Which, yeah, that would straight up be. I mean, I would guess that most of the corrupted ether around Eorzea probably has something to do with Bahamut. Actually, it's what we've been working on for the for Satoru Lanzi's static party. We have done all of binding coils, except T9 and T13, and those are a bitch. So basically, like, what Satoru ends up doing to just keep her Let's Play going is if we can't get a dungeon done, we just unsync it, blaze through it, move on, and then we come back and do it later. So last week we came back to turn 9. And we got the first half pretty down all right. But people were getting very confused with some of the mechanics for the second half. So we weren't able to clear, so that's going to be happening again this weekend. Except that there's two problems with this weekend, being one, J-Pop has his family thing, and also I'm not even able to make it to that because there's a thing downtown that's happening that my friend wants to take me to, and I'm not really sure, like, what the time frame is for that. But it is a thing that that happens all weekend, but if she only has the one day off that that coincides with it, then that's what we gotta do. Bothered to pick that up. Oh, I want to prevent that wall from opening up, I imagine. I'm just going to cause more problems. Not that anything is particularly problematic at this level. this a bit more of an annoying one, because you gotta kill it twice. First folk refuses to die. Oh. Not so much refuses to die as it like gets revived in this thing. And then on the 26th, we're going to be doing World of Darkness. And that feeling when the boss gets more health bars, right? Okay, Pharaoh Sirius. That is a Heavenward dungeon. Back to work. Great. Unfortunately, I will not be going back to work in Tunic because I still don't have a sword. What is next alphabetically? Sestasia. Fantastic. Always love doing Sestasia. No, seriously, fuck Sestasia. There are two dungeons in ARR that are kind of the bane of everyone's existence, especially if they're going for relics. Sestasia and, oh fuck, what's the name of the other one? I am having the biggest brain fart tonight. Ormvale, yes. Because if you're trying to do it at level, then the best way to do it solo is just to run Sestasia over and over again, which is incredibly boring. And if you're doing it unsynced after that, generally a level cap, then you're going to want to unveil because it is short. Probably not even able to trigger this for the advantage. Oh hello, there's a boss now. It's dead. I'm trying to think if I did it. For the rando, anyway. I've ran Ormvale many times. I kind of get what they were going for with ARR dungeons, and they probably even did it in 1.x as well. I wasn't around during 1.x, so I don't have that first-hand experience. But having you do like these like little tasks, like you pick up a key and you use it on the door and it asks you yes or no every time if you want to use the keys. Like, I kind of get it, but I'm glad they don't do it anymore. It's really something that's a little better suited to single player RPGs. Like to use this single use key that only works on this floor? That only works on this door? On this door? No, I would like to eat it. To be fair, there are some dungeons, especially Hawk Manor, where there is one definitive path through the dungeon, but there are extra keys that go to extra doors that sometimes lead to treasure chests. Okay, Sestasha. Normal for gold question. How many questions does that make? Let me open the Universal Tracker and check that out real quick. Slot 5. That's, I don't know how many, but it's still not enough. I would need 30 in order to get the Holy Cross, and then the Holy Cross would let me get a sword or at least a stick, and that would open up that game. I'm gonna skip Sestasha Hard for now, just go somewhere else. The next one on the list is the Lost City of Ambador on Hard. Unfortunately, this sorts the as the rather than the lost as lost. So that's what I'm going by. I think this is a level 60 dungeon. So don't really need to worry too hard about big pulls. Right now, the other ones that are on the list. There's Kugane Ohashi, which is a trial, so what you want to do. Stasha, there's the Orbon Monastery, the Ritorana Lighthouse, and the Royal City of Romanastra, all of which are Alliance raids. And I am going under the assumption that they are excluded from logic. If I'm really running out of checks, then I'll do them. And then there's the Siren Song Sea and the Tintara Deepcraft. On Hard, both of which are light party dungeons and should be included in logic. also one boss down. On we go to the Sanctum of Dreams. It would be nice if I could tell how many faster ones I have without Oh, hello. Another one here. Like, without having to, like, beat into the game. But it wasn't a rock. It was a rock monster! Now that is just a chest. This is what I mean. I guess these structures are very old. This is another chest. I don't know if the actual history of Amphidor. I don't think that Amphidor is all again. Kill you 3 times. What is it these bosses that I have to kill multiple times today? Here you go again. I get knocked down, knocked up again. And third time I stay down. Okay, that was Lost City of Amphidor. That is a Heaven's World dungeon. And that is 5 Sunset Dews. Next up is the Siren Song Sea. This one might be a little rougher, but I think I can still manage it as, as a Reaper here, because this is, no, this is level 60 dungeon. What am I doing? I wouldn't get a level 71 dungeon, because I don't have access to level 71 yet. Brace for impact. I'll just stand right here, the safest possible. Pretty sure that this land doesn't feel on her way to Kurene. The whip jacks. Yeah, I don't really listen to the music anymore. Like when I'm just casually playing by myself, I actually have the music off and usually like watching some video or something like on the side or whatever. I don't really listen to the music, and listening to this, like, is this the song for Lancia? Which makes sense because you do set off for Kugane from Limsa Lamensa. Like this song, at least part of this song, is based on the theme for Kidding. These are little things that you notice sometimes. Number two. Oh, in the cage. I see. Now you don't know that. I see even more. I see more. So we can get the enemies over here. It's like I need. It's like I've been here. I missed the stone. It's fine. We'll stun it out a little bit. It's what I tried to do was I tried to interrupt, which is usually on them six over here, but Reaper doesn't have an interrupt, it has a stun, which I usually put on them three, so I end up doing true north instead of stun. For good measure, where it's gonna hit me at least once. First time it makes you march forward, second time also makes you march forward, the third time makes you march backward. And from there you gotta kind of figure it out from the name of the cast. So that is Siren Song. And that is Stormblood. Sunglasses for Time Swear. Tamterra Deepcroft. On hard. I think that is right here. So all I got left that I plan on doing is this. And then Sestasha hard, then we'll go on break and see what we can do in Castlevania. This dungeon definitely flows a lot better than normal Temtara for sure. Because like those orbs on the altars, you have to actually like click them to dismiss them. This part's a bit annoying. Little side paths. Click on the defiled coffin. If something hits you while you're doing that, you get interrupted. And once you do that, you get frozen for a couple seconds for some reason. gotcha, bitch. Getting that little preemptive hit on Ganon in LTTV before he starts talking. I'm currently diseased, so my movement speed is very slow. Alright, well, thanks for coming by, Grim. Dirty craft. Oh, I got my second element. I mean, I still need shades to get to other parts of the world, but wave is pretty good. Okay, one dungeon left. And that is Sestasha Hard, which is not the same dungeon as Sestasha Normal. That is something that I do wish they would do more, is like, yeah, you got the normal dungeon that brought you through this one path, well, let's go explore it again and see what else we could find. That is something I feel is missing from current content. Drains like really fast, actually. Perhaps a little unrealistic, but also you don't want to be just sitting there for like half a minute watching it go down. This dungeon is a very straight line, as you can see. Well, I mean, it's not a straight line, but there's no, like, both side areas you can go to. It'll just straight up, you go to the place and that's it. And then we get to the end of Sestasha, which actually is the same. Kind of an interesting way of doing. And then this big friend. Hello. Do you have a faded copy of Riptide? I'm pretty sure I already have that one. What's the... There we go. Yeah, I do. It's fine. Okay. And that was the last one that I was planning on doing. Which gives me 5 levels of Blue Mage. Oh boy. Brings me to level 25. Which I definitely do not have. You won't be seeing me play Blue Mage is what I'm saying. Anyway, so that is pretty much everything that our beloved cat girl can do. So we wave goodbye to her and let's go take a look at the board. So here's where we're at. Symphony of the Night has definitive progress, and that's where we're going to be going to after the break. So let's open up the Universal Tracker and see if anything has opened up anywhere else. So first of all, just for good measure, I'm going to double check slot 5 and see that there is nothing there. That's Tunic. Let's check slot 7, which is Crosscode. I don't think we've opened anything up there with Wave, and we have not. Next we will check slot 8, which is Astalon. And it doesn't look like anything opened up there, so that's still in BK mode. Now we got a couple of things for Time Spinner, but yeah, nothing has opened up there. That is still in BK mode. But most importantly, slot 10, Castlevania. Oh, mama, that's a lot of checks. Yeah, we're definitely going there next. Like, let's see, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 48 checks. So we got some work to do. But that is going to be after the break. So y'all can take a moment, get something to drink, go to the bathroom if you need to, stretch your arms, stretch your legs, stretch your teeth, and in about 10 to 15 minutes we shall return with some Symphony of the Night. So, I'll see you in a bit.